Good afternoon, friends. Fundamentally, I was thinking that we should have a review of the circulars issued in relation to, you know, the time gap between two board meetings. If you look at section 173, I'll take section 173. Section 173 is applicable to all companies with a small exception, I can say. Contained in subsection 5 of section 173, which says one person company, small company and dormant company shall be deemed to have complied with the provisions of 173 if they hold at least one meeting in every 6 months. However, they should not be holding meetings like 30th June one meeting and 1st July another meeting. So therefore, they have said at least 90 days gap must be there between two meetings, but nothing prevents the company from holding more meetings, but at least there must be two meetings, and any two meetings there should be at least one set of two meetings where gap is 90 days. So I don't think subsection 5 should be understood coming in the way of a one person company or small company or dormant company meeting on the next day also, though such companies may not have subject matters to be discussed at the drop of a hat. So, leaving aside this type of small companies, one-person companies, etc., look at generally a company which is normally in operations of a given size. 173.1 says that the company shall hold meetings of a minimum number of 4 meetings, which means in a year, they are talking about every year, so there must be at least 4 board meetings whole of the year, and therefore there is a rule that says not more than 120 days shall intervene between two consecutive meetings, which means there can be any number of meetings. There can be once in a 15 days, once in a month also, but you can't have board meetings or in such a way that more than 120 days gap arises between one board meeting and another board meeting. In this context, we have to see what are the things that MCA has issued, because after the advent of the COVID lockdown, difficulties have arisen in relation to holding board meetings in respect of companies, because people have to come from different parts of the country to the venue of the meeting, and there may be also requirements relating to quorum. There may be directors who are not in India, they are coming from abroad, or they have to come from abroad. So there are so many other reasons why the government has thought it fit to give a relaxation to the statutory provision contained in Section 173. The problem of 120 days is this problem comes in the form of a statutory prescription, which means ordinarily nobody is expected to relax it unless you are amending the section itself. However, when the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, which is the administrative department for the Companies Act, is saying that you can hold the board meetings in a different way, there may be more days beyond 120 days. Okay, we can also understand that there may not be a possibility of a prosecution against a company where two board meetings, the gap between two board meetings is more than 120 days. This is the reason, therefore it has come. However, most important thing we have to remember is about the video conferencing facility. Therefore, what happened is the companies, meetings of board and its powers rules 2014, there was an amendment to this rule, which is the important aspect here. They have amended this rule, that is meetings of board and its powers, particularly rule number 4 and sub rule number 1. They have introduced a sub rule number 2, which is saying that for the period beginning from the commencement of company's meetings of board and its powers, amendment rules 2020. These amendment rules have been signed by Mr. K.V.R. Murthy, who is the Joint Secretary to the Government of India and the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, on 19th March. But these rules says they will come into force from the date of its publication in the e-gazette. So I checked what is the date of publication. It is 26th March 2020. So practically this amendment of sub-rule which has been introduced or inserted, sub-rule 2 which has been inserted, comes into force from 26th March 2020. And this amendment says that the video conferencing and other audio visual modes can be used for meetings of the board of directors. So therefore, there is definitely a very important relaxation, which is a need of the hour, and it is practicable also. So barring this particular exceptional amendment which has been brought out by the MCA, the only one other thing the MCA has done is issuing a circular in relation to the time gap between two meetings. Let me take you through the circular, the MCA circular of what date? 11 of 2020, dated 24th March 2020, para number, particularly in this section 173 context, para number 2 must be read. Para number 2 says the mandatory requirement for holding board meetings of companies in with intervals provided under 173 stands extended. 120 days intervals stands extended by 60 days till the next quarter. This rule, this circular came on 24th March, and they are talking about the first quarter of the financial year, that is April-June, and second quarter of financial year, that is you can say July to September. So the circular has come. At the time the circular came also, there may be a lot of anxiety for various companies because the 120 days gap might have been fast approaching or something like that. They might have had a board meeting somewhere in November, December also, and January, February there would not have been any board meeting in some companies. So 120 days may be on the verge of completing 120 days before this 24th March circular, because 25th March, you remember, the first lockdown started. So what happens in this case is that any meeting which is held on any day, you are given a permission up to 180 days extension. For example, let us assume for a minute there is a meeting of board of directors which was last held on the 29th February. So the whole of the March is 31 days, the next is April 30 days, May is 31 days, so 92 days gone, and June 30 days, so it is 122, July is 31, so it is 153, and August you have the other 16 days, I can say, I don't want to count 180 completely. So immediately after the Independence Day, there must be a board meeting for this purpose. So 180 days is a good measure. It is not necessary that companies must wait for this 180 days or last date for this. They can always have the meeting today. Everybody is happily doing webinars and conferences and meetings through various apps like Zoho app, Zoom app, the Microsoft Teams app, Google app, Skype also is also available. So you can always have the venue of the meeting is supposed to be the venue as stated in the notice. And notices to directors can be sent by emails, and the entire recording can be taken and deemed to be happening at the venue of the meeting. If any document is signed, it can be treated as happening at the venue of the meeting. Though different directors would have, different officers, KMPs would have joined the meeting from their respective residences or locations. And irrespective of that, the deeming resolution can be passed at the start of the board meeting, saying that the resolution is deemed to have been passed at this place. Documents which are authenticated by digital signatures of the respective persons are deemed to have been authenticated in the respective places. And there may be timestamp of different jurisdictions, different geographies, different timestamps. Therefore, it is always better to have a deemed resolution clause added in the first of the minutes as the first item of the business, so that everybody is at addendum irrespective of their actual place. Of course, actual place can be recorded, but for the purpose of integrity of the resolution, you can always say the resolution is passed at this place, at this time, and in this mode. And there is nothing wrong in the minutes of the meeting mentioning the persons who have joined, from where they have joined, and you can take declarations from the respective persons that there is no other person who is looking at the proceedings, and no other person is around, no recording is supposed to be done except at the chairman level or the secretary level. So all these precautionary measures can also be taken. If there are documents can be shared, people can view it, and there is nothing this circular or this amendment to the rule says with respect to any other aspect of the board meetings. For example, notes, agenda, the timelines for the sharing of documents, everything must be done in accordance with law. In respect of listed companies also, the SEBI issued two very important circulars. If you see LODR, the only point with respect to number of board meetings and gap between board meetings, you get in regulation number 17, sub-regulation number 3 on the board meeting. Sub-regulation number 3 says The board of directors shall, you know, let me take the sub-regulation number 2, 17.2, I am reading. The board of directors shall meet at least 4 times with a maximum time gap of 120 days between any 2 meetings. So therefore, this is the particular aspect of board meetings relating to the number of board meetings and the gap between 2, maximum gap between 2 meetings. It is at par with section 173 of the Companies Act. So the circular of the SEBI issued says like this. Let me take you through the circular of 16th March. In 16th March, you have a circular which talks about regulation 17 specifically and says that the regulation 17, there is a small, this thing is given. Let me take you through the circulars number 1 and number 2. Okay, yeah. So far as the circular dated 19th March issued by SEBI under LODR relaxation is, the board of directors and audit committee of the listed company are exempted from observing the maximum stipulated time gap between 2 meetings for the meetings held or proposed to be held from 1st December to June 30, 2020. So this circular relaxation is available up to June 30, 2020, hoping that the lockdown will also be given a relaxation at least by 30th June 2020. SEBI is very positive about the issue of corona positive cases, and maybe relaxation will be available. Otherwise, circular will be issued again to give further relaxation. This applies to board meetings and audit committee meetings. It talks about December 1st to 30th June. It says the 120 days, don't worry, chalega, if it is more. But the meetings held between this period only. So it is unlike the MCA circular. This is very, very specific. But for all the meetings held between 1st June 2019 and June 30, 2020, therefore this is one important amendment, relaxation given by SEBI. There is another circular of 16th March, which I will read separately, which is talking about the period of relaxation given is 3 months. Meeting of stakeholders, relationship committee, risk management committee, nomination remuneration committee, which are yearly things. 31st March, wherever due date is there, definitely because of lockdown, it would have been difficult. So they are given 3 months extension up to 30th June. So this is all about, my dear friends, on the board meetings, number of board meetings, as well as the gap between 2 meetings. You would have understood that the whole of the discussion is on the gap between 2 meetings, and it is not about the number of meetings being waived. So there is nothing in the circular or in the amendment or by SEBI in relation to listed companies which says there is no need for 4 meetings. In fact, the circular 19th March very clearly adds, I'm talking about SEBI circular. If you see the SEBI circular, it is specifically saying that the number of meetings must be ensured. So they meet at least 4 times a year is a stipulation which is there in 17.2, which is reproduced in the circular of 19th March. It says definitely you should have 4 meetings. There is no relaxation. Only in the gap between 2 meetings held between 1st December to 30th June, there is a relaxation. Thank you.